Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel, that is Mechanical Engineering Make Easy. In that, I am moving with manufacturing. This is 11th lecture, and in previous lecture we have studied forging, and now we will move with welding. Okay, what is welding? It is one of the metal joining process. For joining two components we use welding. So welding have two types. One is fusion and another is non-fusion. Fusion welding means, in this case, okay, we will not use any pressure, means this is non-pressure welding. And in case of non-fusion, we have to use pressure. So this is pressure welding. Okay, fusion welding means non-pressure welding, and non-fusion welding means pressure welding. So which are the types of fusion welding? They are gas welding, then arc welding and chemical welding. Okay, gas welding, arc welding and chemical welding are the types of fusion welding. And non-fusion welding have the types hot and cold. Hot welding and cold welding. In case of cold welding, the cryogenics and cold pressure welding. Okay. Cryogenics welding and cold pressure welding. These are the types of cold non-fusion or cold pressure welding. That is cold pressure welding and cryogenics welding. And hot welding have types like soldering, then brazing, then resistance welding and braze welding. Resistance welding and braze welding. This is all the classification of hot pressure welding. First is soldering, brazing, resistance welding and braze welding. We will go in detail of number of welding processes. This is only classification. Then in case of gas welding, we have oxyacetylene. Oxyacetylene means C2H2O2. Oxygen acetylene. Then there is air acetylene. Air acetylene. Then there is oxyhydrogen, means H2O2, and atomic hydrogen. Atomic hydrogen. These are the types of gas welding, that is oxyacetylene welding, air acetylene welding, then hydrogen oxygen welding and atomic hydrogen welding. Okay. In case of arc welding, we have AC arc, then DC arc. Then we have MIG, that is metal inert gas welding. Then we have TIG, that is tungsten inert gas welding. Then we have SAW, that is submerged arc welding. Okay, these are the types of arc welding. Then in case of chemical welding, there is only one type of welding, that is thermit welding. Thermit welding. Okay, draw this chart, because this will give you a brief idea of which kind of welding. For example, gas welding is non-pressure welding, means we don't have to use pressure there, only filler material and heat is sufficient to weld. But in case of, for example, soldering, we have to apply some pressure, then only the welding will happen. Okay, so draw this. Again, we have some types of resistance welding. Okay, resistance welding. Resistance welding have some types. They are resistance spot welding, okay, spot welding, seam welding, then percussion welding and projection welding. Percussion welding and projection welding. These are the types of resistance welding, which is nothing but the non-fusion, that is pressure and hot. Hot pressure welding have the type of resistance welding, and resistance welding have spot welding, seam welding, percussion welding and projection welding. These are the four types of resistance welding. Okay, in that the commonly used type is spot welding. Here also commonly used is AC arc and some this is or maybe air acetylene. These are some commonly used welding techniques. Okay, here the soldering is commonly used welding technique. These are 4 to 5 commonly used welding techniques. This is all the classification of welding. Now we will move towards another parameters. Like, share and subscribe my channel so that I will get motivated from you and I will got to know that I am reaching towards true audience. Okay. Then weldability. Weldability is nothing but ability to any material to be welded. Okay. Means, for example, if any material is there, that material is going to welded or not, that property is nothing but weldability. Okay. Capacity of material to be welded. Capacity or ability of material to be welded, that is nothing but weldability. Then we will move with oxyacetylene welding. Okay. Oxyacetylene welding. Oxygen, okay, plus C2H2. This is the formula of acetylene. C2H2 is nothing but acetylene, oxyacetylene welding. Okay, so in case of oxyacetylene welding, there will be two cylinders. Okay, this will contain O2 and this will contain C2H2, and two pipes will be here. And that pipes will be given to welding gun. Here will be the welding gun, we can say, and from which the flame will be generated. Okay, and with the help of this flame, the heat will be given to workpiece. Okay, and as we are providing heat here, so ultimately the material, that workpiece, will melt and the welding will happen. And in some cases we need to require some filler material here. That filler rod will be provided here and the welding will be happen. Okay, this is the very easiest figure of oxyacetylene welding. Here two knobs will be there for passing oxygen and acetylene gas. Okay, so we'll look the types of flame. There are number of types of flame. Okay, which are that? First is neutral flame. What is neutral flame? Neutral flame is nothing but O2 to C2H2 ratio is equal to 1. Means what amount of O2 is there? For example, 1 gram of O2 or 1 meter cube of O2 we have taken, same amount of C2H2 also we are going to take, 1 meter cube of C2H2. Then that is nothing but neutral flame, that will generate neutral flame. Okay, that flame will be likewise okay, and again this distance. Okay, up to this the flame will be very dark and this is the outer portion. Okay, means what exactly the case? This inner portion up to this dotted line, it is dark and the outer portion is light, like yellowish in color, yellowish or orange in color, and this inner portion will be somehow dark, dark orange or likewise. So that dark portion have the length, that is N, denoted by capital N. Okay, and the maximum temperature will be at this tip. Okay, at the tip of that dark portion, maximum temperature will be there, and that T max is 3260 degree Celsius. Okay, 3260 degree Celsius. In case of neutral flame, that T max is 3260 degree Celsius, and this is N. Okay, this N we have to compare with oxidizing flame and reducing flame. Okay, so just take into consideration the n, Tmax, and we will look towards another parameters. And that n will be 10 to 15 mm. Okay, that n will vary from 10 mm to 15 mm. That will depend on intensity of the fuel we are supplying. That is nothing but oxygen and acetylene. How much amount of flow rate we are supplying, that will depend on that. That will vary from 10 mm to 15 mm. Okay. And next parameter is T average. T average for neutral flame will be 2000 to 2100 degree Celsius. This is also important because maximum temperature will be only at the tip, but the average temperature means we can consider this temperature will contain by all the flame, and this amount of depending on the temperature, the amount of heat supplied to the workpiece will vary. Okay, then we will move towards the oxidizing flame, means the oxygen amount will be higher as compared to acetylene gas amount. Oxidizing flame, okay, the inner portion is here, this is N. Okay, for oxidizing flame, O2 to C2H2 will vary from 1.15 to 1.5. okay, the value of ratio of O2 to C2H2 will vary from 1.15 to 1.5, and the maximum temperature will equal to 3380 degree Celsius, and this N, that N will equal to N by 3 to N by 2. Okay, what was the N? This is N for neutral flame and this is N for actual, this is oxidizing flame. So this N will vary from N by 3 to N by 2. If we are assuming that 10 mm of the neutral flame's N, then 10 by 3 to 10 by 2. Okay, means 3.33 to 5. That is the range of N. Okay, and T average for this will be the 2100 to 2200 degree Celsius. Okay, means as maximum temperature increase, ultimately the average temperature also increase. And what happened? As O2 to C2H2 ratio is higher, then ultimately all atoms will get the oxygen atom to burn. Means 100% combustion will happen of acetylene gas. That's why the maximum temperature also increase and average temperature also increase. But ultimately the N value, that is nothing but this value, is decrease. The length of flame will decrease. Okay. Then we will move towards next, that is reducing flame. Means in that case, the oxygen amount is lesser as compared to acetylene gas amount. Okay, so what is that? Carburizing flame. Carburizing flame. So O2 to C2H2 ratio is 0.85 to 0.95. Okay, that value will vary from 0.85 to 0.95. And the N will be increased here. Okay, that N value will be 2 times N to 3 times N. The N value is increased because as acetylene gas is more, so that the length of flame is increased and the maximum temperature is decreased. Okay, maximum temperature decreased because all acetylene gas molecule will not get the oxygen molecule. That's why the incomplete combustion will happen of some acetylene gas. That's why the maximum temperature is decreased. Ultimately, the average temperature also decreased. That average temperature is 1800 to 1900 degree Celsius. Okay, the maximum temperature, average temperature, N value will be increased and maximum average temperature will decrease. Okay, this is all about today's lecture. Now we will move towards bonus points. Bonus points. Okay, what are the bonus points? That is nothing but the flame density. Flame density, which is equal to heat supplied डिवाइडेड बाय एक्सपोजिंग एरिया, एक्सपोजिंग एरिया. व्हाट इज द फ्लेम डेंसिटी, हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ हीट इज कंटेन्ड इन टू दैट फ्लेम, दैट इज नथिंग बट द हीट सप्लाइड अपॉन एक्सपोजिंग एरिया. ओके, दिस इज फ्लेम डेंसिटी. देन फॉर गैस वेल्डिंग टेक्निक्स, नेक्स्ट इज गैस वेल्डिंग टेक्निक्स. ओके, गैस वेल्डिंग टेक्निक्स, देयर आर ओके थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ गैस वेल्डिंग टेक्निक्स. फर्स्ट इज लेफ्टवर्ड और फोर हैंड, लेफ्टवर्ड और फोर हैंड. दिस इज फर्स्ट लेफ्टवर्ड और फोर हैंड. मीन्स व्हाट विल हैपन, द वेल्डिंग विल हैपन इन दिस डिरेक्शन. ओके, मीन्स फ्रॉम राइट टू लेफ्ट द वेल्डिंग विल हैपन. दिस इज नथिंग बट ओके राइट टू लेफ्ट, दिस इज वेल्डिंग कॉल्ड एज लेफ्टवर्ड और फोर हैंड वेल्डिंग. एंड सेकंड इज राइटवर्ड, राइटवर्ड दिस इज डायरेक्टली रिवर्स, मीन्स लेफ्ट टू राइट. एंड इन ऑल केसेस ओके द फिलर रॉड विल बी इन लेफ्ट हैंड एंड द टॉर्च, दैट वेल्डिंग टॉर्च और वी कैन से द वेल्डिंग गन विल बी इन राइट हैंड. ओके, दैट नोट डाउन दैट पॉइंट. एंड देन वर्टिकल वेल्डिंग, वर्टिकल वेल्डिंग मीन्स इफ एनी वर्क पीस इज लाइक वर्टिकल एंड वी हैव टू वेल्ड हियर, सो दैट विल बी द वर्टिकल वेल्डिंग. ओके, देयर विल बी ऑल्सो द इन लेफ्ट हैंड द फिलर मटेरियल एंड इन राइट हैंड द वेल्डिंग टॉर्च और गन, वॉट द वर्ड वी कैन से. ओके, वेल्डिंग टॉर्च विल बी इन राइट हैंड एंड द फिलर रॉड इन लेफ्ट हैंड. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट वॉट आई हैव डिजाइंड फॉर टूडेज लेक्चर. इफ यू हैव एन्जॉयड सेशन देन प्लीज लाइक share, and you are new to my channel then subscribe my channel, and we'll meet again. And from next lecture I am coming with number of different types of welding like air acetylene welding and etc. So up till now, bye bye.